Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Chris Alexiak. I'm a product research engineer at NVIDIA, and I'm extremely excited to showcase to you today our newest open reasoning model, Llama 3.1 Nemotron Nano 4B V1.1. So what is this model? Well, basically, it's another model in our suite of reasoning models that we've released recently, which is provides the user with a reasoning on and off experience, except this time, it's only 4 billion parameters, which means that we can actually run it on a single RTX GPU, as well as Jetson. You'll notice that despite its small size, it punches above its weight class on a number of reasoning, coding, instruction following, and function calling benchmarks compared to its 8B parameter cousins. We're super excited for you guys to use this model. It is, of course, open weight. It inherits the Llama license. As well, we have open sourced the entire training data set, and we've open sourced the pipeline and how to use this from our Llama Nemotron reasoning technical report. So a very open model. How are we going to use the thing, though? For that, we go to Colab. In this Colab notebook, you're going to be able to run the model using vLLM. There is one caveat, which is that you must be using some compute credits here. The free instance T4 is not compatible with the BF16 data type that the model weights are in. So make sure that you're in at least an L40 instance. With that, though, everything else is pretty straightforward. We'll just go ahead and scroll down to cloning the weights. We can clone the weights using git clone. You can safely ignore the LFS errors if you're doing this in Colab. Then we're going to install our vLLM backend. Our vLLM backend is basically just pip installing the latest vLLM. The reason we use the latest is so that we have access to that function calling. We provide the Jenga chat templates as part of the repo, and we want to make sure people can use the tool calling out of the box. If you're using the container version, which instructions for that are available on the model card, please make sure you're using this image or later. Now, you'll notice a few things. Number one is we set the max model length to 50,000. This is just to make sure that this can fit in cards with 14 gigabytes of GPU memory. So that's our lighter weight RTX cards. You can increase this as you have more capacity. For instance, with 20 gigabytes in the L40 instance, you could use 80,000, no problem. If you want to experiment with this, you can try the different lengths, and vLLM will tell you before it starts the server whether or not you have enough GPU capacity. For this, though, so let's just leave it at 50K, which is still a heck of a lot of tokens. You'll also notice that we have these tool parser plugins, tool calling parser, and our chat template. Again, this is what lets us have this functionality of tool calling out of the box with vLLM. You'll also notice that we're using NoHub. All NoHub is doing is letting us run the vLLM server in Colab without blocking the rest of the notebook so that we can safely use the rest of the notebook while our server is running. You can check the logs to make sure that the server is booting up. When this cell completes running, it means that the server is booted up, and we can go ahead and start playing with this model. So how do we use this thing? Well, there's some guidelines that we want to talk about. Again, this is a reasoning on and off model. Reasoning on and off is controlled via the system prompt, which must be set to one of these two values. We aren't going to put instructions into the system prompt, which is a pattern you may be used to. Instead, we're going to put all those instructions into the user prompt, and that's going to allow you to have the best experience with instruction following, function calling, and everything else with this model. For reasoning on mode, we're going to recommend using a temperature of 0.6 and a top P of 0.95. And for reasoning off mode, we're going to use greedy decoding. Greedy decoding just means temp equals zero. Give us the next most likely token. Okay, so now that we have it spun up, we've got some idea of how to use it. Let's see how we do it in practice. First thing we're going to do is we're going to point our OpenAI client at our vLLM instance. We do not need to provide an API key, so we just pass in dummy. And let's look at how we would handle like an arithmetic reasoning problem, right? So we have a bookstore sold 120 books on Monday and 150 books on Tuesday. If they aim to sell 400 books by the end of Wednesday, how many books must they sell on Wednesday? Right? So a little bit of a think it through question. You can see that the correct response will be 130. In this case, we pass detailed thinking as on. We pass in our user prompt. When we create our messages, you'll notice again that the system prompt only has this detailed thinking on message. And then we put everything else in our user prompt. We set our temperature to 0.6, our top P to 0.95. And then we go ahead and we stream the response. So you'll see the model does what you'd expect. It produces many thinking tokens. It thinks a lot. And then finally, we get an answer in the box format. which is what we'd expect of 130. We'll go next to a reasoning off example. In this case, we're going to use detailed thinking off, and we're just going to ask a simple question like, what is NVIDIA? You'll see again in our system prompt, we only have detailed thinking off, and then in our user prompt, we pass in the user prompt, all of our payload. You'll also notice that we're using temperature equals zero since we're using detailed thinking off. We want that greedy decoding. And you can see here that there are no thinking tokens produced. It just goes straight to the output, and that's all we needed. Perfect. Okay. You may notice that there's some emergent behavior where the model decides to think through a problem even when you have asked it not to. In this case, we can go ahead and we can pre-fill the assistant prompt with this snippet here. This is going to make sure basically that the model does no thinking as a guarantee. Finally, we have our tool calling example. Our tool calling example is going to be very straightforward. It's just going to showcase we have some tools. We have our system prompt, which is detailed thinking on, and we have our user prompt, which is whatever task we wish to do. And then you can see that the model does indeed use those thinking tokens in order to determine which tool that it needs to call. So this is the idea. Even though this is a reasoning model, we've done a lot of work to make sure that it's a pleasant experience for tool calling as well as instruction following, so you can use it in your agentic workflows. Finally, just have some fun. We've provided a little playground for you so that you can attack different prompts. In this case, I have asked, what is the heaviest metal? It gives a very detailed answer depending on what I meant by heaviest, showcasing that advanced reasoning capability. All right. Thank you so much for your time, guys. I've been Chris Alexiak. Thank you so much for watching. Links in the description, and we'll see you in the next one.